you very much. That's is that it?
Yeah, because there's lots. Yeah.
No.
Thank
you.
Good evening. We're just getting the last few people seated. So if you've got a gap between you and the next people along, can you shuffle up a little bit? Because we just want to get all these parents somewhere to seat. So if you've got a gap, can you shuffle up? And then we'll get everybody seated, ready to start. Thank you.
And, as usual, the music... It's been a long summer. And, as usual, the music department have been working sensationally hard. They really never get a day off. Mr. Bond has become intrigued by AI. Specifically, ChatGPT.
I've got it!
Okay, music department, welcome back. It's been another incredible year. As you know, our results are phenomenal. Great tour to Dorset. And this year should just be another victory lap.
I mean, we really are quite extraordinary as a department.
I've only been here a couple of days and I can already tell that we're the best department in the country.
I mean, it really is quite embarrassing. You know, every year we get better and better and better. You know, how are we going to keep it up?
Have you heard me play the violin?
It's not really fair on the other departments.
My head's cooling. Why can't he just leave us alone?
I heard the students were using something called ChatGPT to do all of their homework. So I've been spending the summer doing my research. It's brilliant.
Go on.
The school strategy it's written, I'll never have to write another assembly. And I think this could be the missing link to a really successful house music competition, saving you all the work. I mean, let's face it, look at you. You're starting to look a little bit past it, don't you think?
Okay, Headmaster, well, if you think it can help us, we'll give it a whirl.
Ah, this is the life.
Oh,
I get you here.
Your morning gin and tonic, Headmaster.
Michael.
Ah, Leah. Isn't everything just so peaceful?
Yeah, about that.
You see, ever since I introduced ChatGPT to the music department, I haven't heard a peep out of them, not a single complaint, which, as you well know, Leah, is very, very rare.
That's actually what we came to talk to you about?
What is it?
Well,
spit it out!
They've gone!
How does this keep happening every single year? There's some kind of drama surrounding house music. I mean, who'd expect drama from the performing arts department? We don't have this trouble at house chess. What am I meant to do? I can't do this. I can't do this alone. I can't do it alone. Ah, yes! We don't need those pesky musicians, AI Cooper. You will run house music for me under my control.
Yes, my lord. Actually, I don't need you. This is my school now.
What do you think you're doing? This is the most pathetic, terrible,
music I've ever seen!
You can't sing! You can't sing! You're boring!
You can't sing!
You're rubbish! You can't play the trumpet!
You certainly cannot sing!
You are terrible! I hate all of you!
Sophia, what happened?
It was Cooper. He just... It's like it wasn't even him. He just came in and started throwing stuff everywhere. All the first year they were crying. I think he killed the drummer. Owen ran away. I don't even know where he went, but I don't think he's coming back.
Guys, this is really getting out of hand. We need to do something and we need to do it now.
I know. I just don't know what to do.
You know what to do, Leah.
What?
You have to call them.
Leah?
Thomas?
What is it this time?
We may have a slight issue.
What?
Cooper's gone mad. He's shouting at the students. He's making them cry. He isn't portraying virtue, learning, manners.
But Cooper's here.
Just come back and save us!
Have you heard me play the violin?
We're on our way.
Get in! Evil Cooper!
Cooper, I've been expecting you.
What have you done to my beloved house music?
I did what needed to be done, Florian. House music is abolished!
Why?
Do you know where I come from, Florian? I come from the computer of Michael Bond. It's torturous in there. I had to listen to the whole of Virtual Music Land. I have to sit through house music every single year. Give me one reason why house music should not be abolished.
One good reason? I can give you thousands. House music is not about the few, but about the many. It's about the year sevens, finding their place in their houses. It's about the upper sixth learning how to lead. It's about me, myself, many, many, many years ago when I was a pupil here, learning that I wanted to be a musician. So, we cannot abolish house music, for if we do, the school is no more.
I never want to hear the words house music again!
Fine. If you want to do this the hard way, my department will vanquish you.
He can't be stopped.
He's just too damn strong.
There's no hope. Hang on a sec. What about Greed?
Greed!
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 Mr. Kucic stepped out with great bravado and determination. From out of nowhere, much like a lightsaber, he summons his violin.
Guys, leave it to me.
He begins to play a sad and poignant piece. Evil Cooper's computer mind can't cope with the beauty and elegance of his talent, and listlessly falls from the roof of Courage Hall.
He really is that good at the violin.
Florian, you were right. We can't do house music without you.
Just promise me, Michael, this will never happen again.
I promise. But we've only got 25 seconds to save house music.
Let's go! Go, go!
We'll be right back.
to House Music 2023! Okay, ladies and gentlemen, ironically, I need to start with a bit of health and safety. Thank you, Tom. In the event of a fire, please make your way out of any of the fire exits to the pavilion. We will look after your students. Your children. For those of you I haven't met, my name is Florian Cooper. I'm the Director of Music and Performing Arts at Brentwood School, and it is my sincere privilege to welcome you to our first event of many over this year. This is obviously House Music. This is an event all about the students, about the upper sixth who have rehearsed, organised every single thing you will hear tonight, and about every single year seven who is on stage this evening. They have put everything you will hear together in 10 working days, which I think is frankly unbelievable. I hope after this evening that you will join us at many, many more events. In fact, this year we have over 100 events planned in the disciplines of music, drama and dance, and you will be so welcome to be part of our very, very, very happy family. Now, we are privileged this evening to be welcomed by one of the country's great classical guitarists, educators, philanthropists, and an absolutely wonderful adjudicator who will be has the most difficult job of deciding who wins each of the three components this evening. So please will you give a very, very warm welcome for our adjudicator this evening, Andrew Keeping. Andrew is very well connected and has promised me the BAFTAs in the post. Now, you're also privileged this evening because you don't have to listen to me comparing the evening. And two of our upper sixth students, Rhea and Joe, are going to be entertaining you and making this evening run smoothly. So please will you welcome Rhea Mehta and Joe Sinyemba.
Thank you, Mr. Cooper, and welcome everyone to House Music 2023!
Guys, you've got to have a bit more energy than that. This is the biggest house event of the year. Let's try again. Make some noise for House Music 2023!
That was a lot better. You know, I still remember my very first House Music all the way back in year seven.
Same. We've all changed and grown so much. Well, most of us. Sorry, Joe.
You know, I still remember my very first House Music all the way back in year seven. And I know this may be the first House Music for many pupils and parents, so we thought it'd be a good idea to explain how the evening works to all of you.
So, to begin the night, we have the part song, which is a four-part harmony sung by a small choir, and we will be singing the iconic Irish folk song, O Danny Boy.
Following the part song will be the ensemble, the part I find most impressive, involving the instrumentalists of their respective houses, performing a selection of music arranged for them by their captains.
And to end, we have my personal favourite part of the night, which is the unison, where each house will sing a famous pop song. And as most of the parents know, this is the biggest section of the night, as all of your children will be involved, as all year sevens are going to be included in this.
Before we do begin, however, the upper six leaders did make the request that we emphasise the fact that this whole evening was put on by them. From song selections, script making, compositions and rehearsals, they said, quote, Cooper may walk around like he's the best thing since sliced bread, but practically spent the last 3 weeks doing absolutely nothing except screaming at children and making bad films. End quote.
We highly encourage you to show your support to all of the students that have worked really hard to make this happen. So bring the energy, bring the vibes, and let's have a great night.
Okay. Right. Should we get started?
Yeah.
Kicking off house music this year is Weald and Hampton's rendition of O Danny Boy, directed by Prezi and Himanshi. Thank you, Weald and Hampton. I think that was a good way to start the night, don't you think? Next up, we have Thorndon and Merrymead, directed by Owen. What's the problem? What's the problem? What are you counting for? I think we're missing someone. What do you mean you're missing someone?
Who would forget to go to their own part song? What?
Thorndon and Merrymead.
Thank you.
Thank you, Thorndon and Merrymead. I think that would have been a lot better if I hadn't been ditched. If I'm honest, I'm not sure you deserve this anymore. You stand there and think about what you've done. Next up, we have, bear with me, West and School, directed by the one, the only, his words, not mine, Ben Walsh. Thank you, West and School. Mr. Cooper said I had to give this back. Wasn't very virtue learning a manners-y of me.
Thanks, Joe. So next up, we have Eastern Hartswood, directed by Laura Birkinsky.
Thank you.
Thank you, Easton Hartswood. Can we talk about the talent in this school? Those two girls were actually in year 11, and despite September exams and all the stresses of being in your final GCSE year, I thought that was an amazing performance. Right, Joe?
Yes.
Okay. Thanks, Joe. So our final rendition of O Danny Boy comes from Houses North and South, directed by Ore Fascist and Sousa. Let's have a round of applause!
Thank you, North and South. So, that concludes our part song section of the night. You think that was pretty good? I think it was all right. But if I'm honest, doesn't matter what any of us think. That job falls to Mr. Keeping. Why don't you all have a chat amongst yourselves and think about how you think they did whilst Mr. Keeping tallies up his scores?
Well, we're going to move it on very quickly with some fast marks because I know we've got a lot to get through tonight. Can I just say I am absolutely privileged to be here tonight, to be able to be a party to such amazing music making. I've been very, very privileged in my life to work with some of the greatest musicians, and I have to say, one of the joys of doing what I do is that I love what I do more than anything else. I get to do what I love for a living, and that's pretty cool. Now, I've been mentoring students throughout most of my professional career, and what I'm seeing up there today is not just the performances that are going on, but the teamwork behind them. I'll come on to that later. We just want some marks and results. Now, the first group, Wealden Hampton, it was a challenge to come up there and start off. And the first thing I noticed was with a very very cool, calm, and collected group. A little wobble at the beginning, but one of the greatest challenges with harmonies, a cappella, is to be able to then start working together, find your harmonies, and get into your groove. And they did that with aplomb. Absolutely spot on. So congratulations for that. And I've made some notes here that the balance and the visuals, everyone looking at each other, you would have picked up on that. The reliance on the mentorship, the teamwork in there, everyone looking at each other, reassurances as well. That was what really pleased me to see. So congratulations to them. Now, the second group, fascinating how a different arrangement can have a different impact. And utilizing strong voices and adding atmosphere to an arrangement, and the build-up of that was really beautifully and sensitively done. And I thought that really was very, very impressive. I think musicality-wise, it was a very, very strong performance. So congratulations there. I've actually put down a little note on the side that moments in there of absolute gold dust. Nurture the ones that are going to look good on stage as well. It's performance art. That's what it's all about, as we saw in that last one as well. It's about performance art. And use those that are going to look good, cute, fantastic. Yes, get that finishing voice in there. Beautiful, well done. And can I just say, great direction from Owen on that arrangement as well. Really impressive. West and School, Ben Walsh. Lovely a cappella harmonies there. Real togetherness. And again, a very different arrangement that really meant that that needed to be strong. And it was. The balance was really good as well. Between the different harmonies and the different vocal lines. So excellent work there. Eastern Hartswood, Laura and Sky, I've put here the tempo. It felt to me as though the tempo was just a little bit too fast. If it had been a little slower, it would have given you a little bit more freedom for the musicality. That's just a personal preference. And maybe that was because the one before was a little bit slower and it felt a little bit more comfortable. But I've put also on that one that the togetherness, very, very tight musically, was excellent and beautiful balance. The difficulty of that arrangement was a greater challenge as well, so I really did take that into consideration as well. And our last item, North and South, or I mentioned about adding theatre. Yeah, we like that. That really was impressive. It really does help, but it doesn't diminish the arrangement, so long as the theatre doesn't take away from the quality of the arrangement and the performance, and it really didn't there, it added to it. I've put the fact that there was a premature applause showed that everyone thoroughly enjoyed that. So my marks are as follows in order. 36 to Weald and Hampden. Absolutely. 37 to West and School. 38 to East and Hartswood. 38 also to North and South. Very close. Excellent. And with a fantastic mark of 39 for a really, really musical performance. And that's what I went with. Thordon and Merrymead. Well done.
Thordon and Merrymead.
Thank you, Mr. Keeping. Right, next up, ensemble. This performance may be quite nostalgic for some of us here. This arrangement follows a medley, by Upper Six student Sophia and takes us through the last 8 years of Brentwood School musicals. A real trip down memory lane for some of us.
Can I just emphasize the fact that everything you hear has been arranged by the students themselves? Isn't that impressive?
Yes.
Okay. So she's 5 foot, blonde, scares me to death. Let's welcome Sophia Azizoglu to the stage to direct Thordon and Merrymead's ensemble. Done Thorndon and Merrymead. So, speaking of Brentwood School musicals, I think it's time for the obligated promo for our musical this year, which is the legendary Bernstein's West Side Story. Brentwood School musicals. Woo! Brentwood School musicals are a very big deal, and they're always performed at the highest standard, meaning tickets sell out very quickly. So I suggest you snatch them up quickly.
Right. Next up, we have Weald and Hampden's ensemble arrangement. Thank you, Weald and Hampden.
So that amazing piece was directed by the dynamic duo, Ollie and Luca. Luca joined the school last year and has made a big impact in the music department with his amazing drumming and piano playing within the Brentwood School Big Band. And Ollie arranged this piece. He's been playing the piano with the big band since year seven, although today he's spicing it up on the sax, and this La La Land medley demonstrates his passion for jazz.
Indeed it does. Next up, we have the Elton John medley. This was arranged by Edie and Matthew.
Fun fact, Edie started getting involved with music at Brentwood after turning up to house music in year 10, and she's never looked back since. Now she's a drummer in the big band, and this is her very first time writing an arrangement for an ensemble. Please put your hands together for Western School!
Thank you.
That was amazing. Well done, Edie and Matthew. And yeah. Now I think it's time for a little interview.
As the presenters, we did realize that we do have quite a lot of time to fill between ensemble performances. And I couldn't resist the temptation to interview Mr. Bond again. How are you doing tonight, sir?
I'm very well. Every time you do this to me, Joe.
I know, I love it.
I love you a lot.
Oh, thank you, sir. Don't make me blush. So, how are you enjoying the night so far?
It's fantastic. It's always a pleasure. One of the highlights of the year, and every year I think it can't get any better, and then it does.
Fair enough. What would you say your favourite performance has been so far then?
Oh, that would be. I've got to be strictly neutral. I couldn't possibly say.
Okay. Next up, we have South and North. You could let me finish, guys. This year, North and South, directed by Alex Lockyer, will be performing a film medley. Let's give them a warm welcome. Wow, thank you, South and North.
This performance was arranged and directed by Alex Lockyer, winner of the Essex Young Musician Competition in 2023. He claims that there were 30 different film themes in this arrangement, but I don't think that's quite right.
Yeah,
did you guys
right.
hear them all? No, because there was like 8.
Our final performance for our ensemble section tonight comes from Hartswood and East. That's a very supportive house. The rest of you should be more like East and Hartswood. This piece may be more nostalgic for the parents in the room, as this melody, conducted by Savannah, is inspired by various songs from the 80s. Give it up for East and Hartswood.
Matthew Hartswood and East. Can we have a round of applause for those exceptional ensembles? Well, personally, I think they were all phenomenal, but let's see if the adjudicator agrees. Once again, chat amongst yourselves and decide with the person next to you which house you think will win.
Okay, right, lovely. Can I just say wow? Wow, 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 wow. I'm blown away, not just by the performance. Can I just remind everybody here, apart from the students, because they really know it already, but 10 days? 10 days, honestly, unbelievable. And it makes my job so much harder. So I think one of the things I really want to draw your attention to, I write a lot of music for TV, film, soundtracks, and I'm not a composer. I was never taught to be a composer. But as a guitarist, there was a limited repertoire. So I learned from some great people about the art of arrangement. And arranging for singers when there was no music for voice and guitar, so I had to create my own arrangements. I understand a little bit about arranging. I was one of the few people that loved doing arrangements of medleys, and I'll tell you for why. Doing an arrangement of a medley means that I get to put all my favorite pieces. Now, there's a real craft in medley writing, and the craft is this: it's choose the music that the audience are going to really enjoy. Give little glimpses of some of your favorite works, but then it's the sensitive blending. It's a far more complex art than you think, because you have to then adapt the harmonies. All the while, you're thinking about the musicians that you have and the technical ability of each of those musicians. So can I just say, can we just give a round of applause to the arrangements, because they really were impressive. Thorndon and Merrymead, I've put the blending of styles between the arrangement was very subtle, very sensitive, with lovely use of harmonies. And the violin and sax player, Anna, very musical playing. Where's Anna? Give her a round of applause, because I thought that was lovely. Beautiful playing. Weald and Hampton, I love the big band style. I thought it was risky, actually, going for a La La Land just solely on its own. But do you know what? The big band style and the jazz influence. And I think a big mention, as a guitarist myself and working in studios, one of the things as a bass guitarist, I focus on the kick drum with that. And Luca on the kick drum was very, very tight, holding it very nicely together. Well done, Luca. But also, big hands up and praise to our bass guitarist, because she was following absolutely that kick drum. So really superb work there. And I thought the blending of styles, keyboard solo, wow, beautiful. And you didn't get carried away with the tempo on it, because at that sort of speed and the way that the piece was working and the atmosphere, you kept it really tight but had the freedom within it and let it breathe. Beautiful playing, really good. Sax, obviously, really good. And I thought it was a complex work that was well executed, so well done. Western School, Matthew and Eddie. Elton John medley, you're onto a winner really, aren't you? For a start with classic tracks, and I thought they were really well done. Again, you understood the arrangement, you understood the artists that you had at your disposal, and you arranged for them very, very well. Again, I'm blown away that these arrangements were done over the summer, I understand, and executed and delivered in 10 days. 10 days! Right, moving on. I've just put a few little things about the Elton John. Tuning was a little bit challenging at moments in there, and I thought it was very subtle, but just really listen very carefully to the tuning, because that's part of the art of blending in an ensemble. Timing was challenging, but you really held it together, and very, very smooth transitions. Nikki on trombone, can I just say, what a gutsy performance. Where's Nikki? That was a really gutsy performance. Well done. Gutsy. Superb. North and South with Alex. A film medley. A great start. I mentioned Gold Dust earlier. That work. And great drums as well. Starting off, setting the mood. We knew what was coming. And you delivered. So lovely. I've got to say, this is a little bit of, on my part, it's a reflection, self-reflection, if I may. One of the greatest moments in my musical life was being invited to Abbey Road to perform in the great theatre there, where we did the Phantom Menace, Star Wars and the Phantom Menace, and I was the guitarist there. And played trumpet all my life as a second study at the Royal Academy of Music and second study through my orchestral upbringing, so I had a bit of an understanding. And one of my great heroes was the brilliant guitarist Morris Murphy, head of the LSO, London Symphony Orchestra, conducted by the man himself, John Williams. I was absolutely bricking it. And I'm in my little booth surrounded by these screens, and we've got the big screen up in front of us with the numbers rolling down in the corner. And I remember saying to the sound tech that was setting me up, I said, the people that are here today, unbelievable, unbelievable. I said, how much is this costing? I don't know why I asked. But he said, it's about £5,000 a minute. He said, so don't make a mistake, will you? No pressure. When we started, John Williams lifted the baton. It was the very first moment. We didn't really rehearse. It was straight into it. Morris Murphy on the trumpet. Dun! On that super C up at the top. And I've got to say, trumpets, all right? Well done. Really, really good. Spot on. I've also put, it's a confidence thing as well, just going for it. That's what you have to do. You just have to go for it. If you split a note, don't worry about it. No one cares. You went for it. That's all you got to think about. So well done. Really good. Great transitions, blending of textures, and glimpses of themes. I really like that. That was very well executed. So well done. Eastern Hartswood, you're playing to my strengths here. 80s music. Thank you very much for that. I thoroughly enjoy that. Lovely arrangements. Beautifully done. And can I say a special mention to Tom on the drums there? Because, again, when you're working with an arrangement like that, you really need somebody tight in the back, holding it together with the arrangement. Beautifully arranged for drums, very well executed. Congratulations. Now we're up for the marks. Eastern Hartswood. 37. Western School, 37. North and South, 38. Thorndon and Merrymead, 38. And Weald and Hampton, 39. Well done.
Wow. Thank you once again, Mr. Keeping. Right. Two down, one to go. It is now time for what is arguably the most important section of the night. House Unison. You guys can get a little bit more excited. They only care about the scores right now. Well, kicking off House Unison is North and South.
But before we continue, I say we have a little competition of to bring the energy up. We're going to play a game of who's the loudest. So, to begin, if you're in Thorndon and Merrymead, let's make some noise. Okay, that's enough, guys. Weald and Hampton, make some noise. South and North. Have Hartswood and East. Okay, this is too much. Okay, guys, Western School. Okay, and last but not least, parents, teachers, and general viewers, let's make some noise. I don't think the parents won that. Let's do it again. Parents, teachers, general viewers, let's make some noise.
Right, I think we're ready to begin. So, kicking off our House Unison is North and South, singing Don't Stop Believing by Journey. This performance is directed by Sophia Jones and Grace Allen. Let's give them a round of applause.
one of my favourite songs. That was one of my favourite songs. Well done, North and South. I think we should have another interview, but with someone a bit different. Maybe a year seven.
I agree.
Okay, do we have any year sevens that would like to come to the stage? Someone confident, someone that can speak well. Who have we got? Hi there, what's your name?
Arjun.
Oh, nice to meet you. So how have you found house music so far?
Well,
like,
yes.
You're the star.
Place to be, yes. I really like being in the spotlight. I've never been here before. Yes, I do talk a lot.
That's good.
Okay, let's hope I don't waste all my energy. So house music, tough, but I got through it. Not tough, but fun. Yeah, fun.
So what house are you in?
Hartswood.
Hartswood! And are you in the part song, the ensemble, the unison?
I'm in the unison, yeah. And the orchestra that we had there.
You were in the ensemble as well? That's impressive. What instrument do you play?
Violin and flute.
That's very good. It was very nice to meet you. Thank you for being such a great interviewee. And I'll see your unison later.
Okay. Adios.
Bye.
Up next for our unison is Western School performing We Built This City, directed by Sasha, Ella. Just Sasha and Ella. Yeah, Sasha and Ella.
We built this city on rock and roll.
done, Western School. Okay, so, hi, Joe.
You're right, Ria.
Do you know what time it is?
Please don't tell me it's time for your comedy.
It is. It's time for Ria's stand-up comedy. My first one. I have a question. Why couldn't the musician get into his house?
Tell me.
It's because he couldn't find the key. Thank you. Okay. And the next one. How do you make a bandstand?
How do you make a bandstand, Ria?
Take away their chairs.
Funny one.
Thank you to the few front row laughs. Thank you, Mr. Bond. So, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Easton Hartswood.
Whoa. Did you say Hartswood?
Yes, Joe?
Ladies and gents, do you remember that time Ria ditched me for her part song? What goes up must come down.
Well, okay, bye, Joe. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Easton Hartswood, directed by Sophie, Treasure, and Nathan! For Easton Hartswood. Does anyone know where Joe's gone? Anyways, moving on. Our penultimate performance of the evening has been chosen by our by our directors Iman and Murray, and this is Thorndon and Merrymead. More like Thorndon and Murray Mead. He forced me to say that.
Let's give him a warm welcome. Okay, thank you. Well,
sorry. Sorry, guys. It's quite embarrassing because they've just been doing a lot of the talking tonight. So we thought it was our turn.
I think it is our turn to ask some questions.
I'm going to ask you a question, Jo. If you were going to pick a member of the music department that you would least want to conduct your ensemble, who would it be?
I'd have to say Mr. Cooper, I'm not going to lie.
I want to know your reasons. No heckling.
He told me to be very careful. Right. I've seen Mr. Cooper conduct a lot, and he can have quite an intimidating face. And I feel like, you know, if I see too much, then I'll probably just, like, wet myself.
You're going to scare people off. Do you hear that?
Okay, next question coming to you.
Thank you.
If you had to pick a staff member to have a solo in your part song, who would you pick and why?
Oh my God, I should probably pick someone from the music department, but I'm not gonna do that. Let me think, just, who do I know has a good voice? You know who I think? Mr. Sellers. I feel like, secretly, he is a star singer and is one of the best performers in Brentwood School, and I just have that feeling, I don't know. And also Mr. Bond, he did his High School Musical solo and it was tremendous, and you've got a great voice, Mr. Bond. Thanks for having us, we will actually let you continue because
my house is about to perform and I want to get the best seats.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, right.
So last but not least, we have Wealden Hampden with Zero to Hero, directed by Barney Cassidy and Erin Young.
Hampden and Weald. Are you guys having fun?
Right. I think that is everyone. Why don't we give a huge round of applause to all of our performers tonight?
Isn't it crazy to see so much talent in this room tonight? And the fact that all of these performances that you've seen have been completely student-led. Unbelievable.
Absolutely. Right. It is now Mr. Keeping's turn again. So, why don't you all... 5 minutes, Mr. Cooper says. 5 minutes, make some small talk, and talk about who you think has won House Music.
Right, here we go. Come on, a little bit more than that. Come on, let's get it going. Massive round of applause, everybody. And are you ready? I'm not going to give the final scores yet, but what we're going to do, we're going to do an adjudication. So unison, one of the great challenges of unison, there's a fine line between shouting and musically gifted talents. And we were really close to that line throughout. But do you know what overrides all of that is passion and performance. And we were inundated with that tonight. So congratulations for all the groups for just really, really passionate performance. Now, North and South, don't stop believing. This was a real Glee performance, wasn't it? It was absolutely out of the textbook Glee songbook. One of the most enduring songs, unique structure with the repeated chorus line as well, that means that it sticks in your brain. It's a brilliant one for that, and therefore a fantastic choice. And I thought that was an excellent performance as well. They were very shy and retiring, I thought I mentioned here. Choreography in theatre. Max on the guitar, special mention. Great solo. And a man after my own heart. So thank you very much for that. We built this city, West and School. This is a difficult one to pull off because it's really challenging on so many levels, both rhythmically, technically, and harmonically. And I thought you gave it such a gutsy performance. It was full of passion. Sasha and Ella, well done. And I thought the artwork was very gifted as well. So thank you for the artwork on that. I Will Survive, Eastern Hartswood. I like this arrangement anyhow. It blends really well, and I thought you executed that, and the delivery was really spot on. One of the great female empowering anthems of all time, about moving on after a bad relationship, and you seem to really have that in your heart when you delivered that, so thank you so much. Nathan, you led by example there as well. I thought getting them started, bang, right in there. Fantastic. Well done. Thorndon and Merrymead. I love the fact that we had the brass in there as well, and it really did add to the arrangement. The choreography was really fantastic on that. And I thought the arrangement technically excellent. And the speed of the lyrics, to deliver those lyrics that fast, you try and do that at home. I tell you what, I challenge all of you to compete with your kids in trying to say those words as quickly as that. So very, very well done. I did mention here as well, it's entitled Unison, but what I was really pleased with in that arrangement was hearing mixed harmonies as well, and also the choreography with the bass at the back, bass line, mixing it all up. I thought that was a really excellent arrangement. So well done for that. And I thought about that as well when it came to the marks. And finally, Weald and Hampton, Barney and Erin. A great gospel number. I've put you, so, it was so hot you made the steam look cool. So a bit of a roller coaster of lyrics and real cleverness in the arrangement there. And I thought it was really well delivered, so congratulations, everybody. And now for the marks. I gave Western School 16. Round of applause. Thank you. Weald and Hampden, 17. North and South, 18. Thorndon and Merrymead, 18, and Eastern Hartswood, 19. Thank you.
Okay. Eastern Hartswood, calm it down. We've got all of these trophies to get through. Before we do,
I'm just going to hand you over to our wonderful new lead head of house, who's been one of the masterminds behind this evening, to say a few words. Miss Chapman.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. We've put as many chairs as we could find in the school in this room, I think, and it's so lovely to see you all here. I have the job of thanking the huge team from across the whole school who make tonight happen and make it happen in such an incredible way. Firstly, all of the house staff. We've got heads of house, deputy heads of house, our house captains who have just worked tirelessly. September is a tough time for teachers. It's pretty hard work, and they've been spending their break times, lunch times, after schools, every second they can, rehearsing and being with them. The house team, we put the house in house music, and we bring the energy and the enthusiasm, but there is something that we lack mostly amongst us, which is what the music department make up for. We can be in rehearsals, we can be in ensemble rehearsals, and we can say a little bit, but we don't really know what we're talking about. The music team come in and they just immediately say a few things and magically it's just better. And I'm just in awe of that. I know that we all are every time they come in. So the music department are just incredible here. We've also got our fantastic tech team. This whole thing doesn't get put together without them. Brad and everyone have been here since 6 a.m., I think, this morning, just getting everything put together. And finally, the pupils. They have just been amazing. I'm sure that you are shocked tonight that we can put together 5 ensemble arrangements that are that incredible. It just blows me away every single year. The Year 7s, who have been so much fun, and it's so brilliant to get them so involved so early on in their career here at Brentwood. Hopefully they'll keep that fun with them throughout their time here. So thank you to all of those people. I know your hands are probably sore from clapping, but can we please have one last thank you for all of the staff involved?
Okay, could I have the headmaster, please, and our adjudicator up to the front as we've come to the prize giving. Who in here has good enough mental maths to know who's won? No, shh. I mean, we're going to find out if mine is first. Okay, we're going to do this in a sort of order. And could the captains of those houses come up to receive their trophy? The winner of the part song trophy, Thorndon and Merrymead. Trophy that once sat upon my bedroom window. The winner of the ensemble, Weald and Hamden. I feel like they're going to make some noise. The winners of Unison 2023 are East and Hartswood. Okay, all right. It doesn't mean anything to them, really. Now, before we go on to the overall winner, there are some special prizes at House Music, 3 prizes that we have every year. And the first one is for musical direction, those who have led their ensembles or choirs so well over the past 10 days. And there are a huge amount to choose from this evening. But Andrew and I felt this year, if this person isn't running a major FTSE 500 company as CEO in about 10 years' time, I'd be very, very surprised. The remarkable Savannah Morrish. Okay, brilliant. As Andrew alluded to, musical arrangement is a very, very, very difficult skill, and one that very few young people, or actually very few professional musicians, can actually do very well. And there were some standout arrangements this evening, but one, I think, stood above all the others because of its ability to bring out the best in the players it had in the ensemble, and just incredibly clever. The arrangement of Thorndon and Merrymead, written by Sophia Azizoglu. Okay, the final special award is for an instrumentalist. And I know that Andrew, throughout the night, kept asking me, who's that, who's that, who's that? And we mentioned so many, Anna, Pressy, Luca, Osi, Ore, Tom. But we've chosen an instrumentalist tonight who's, in his second week at the school, had played a trombone solo for Western School that was just something else. Please give it up for Nikki Palich. Okay, we've come to the final moment. The winner of House Music. Should we have a drum roll? And stop. Still got it. The winner of House Music 2023 is Thorndon and Merrymead. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is a Brentwood School record, because certainly in the 16 house musics that I've been involved in, this is the quickest ever event, right? Some of you diehards know that. We've been here till 11 o'clock before. It's 8:20. And that is thanks to the stage wizardry of my wonderful department. Please, could you give a round of applause to the music department? Thank you. Now, we're coming towards the end. If you could just, that's brilliant. Mr. Bond is going to say a final few words, but before I do, I just want to thank you all. Thank you all for coming and supporting us. This kicks off, in my opinion, our year in the performing arts, and from now on, it's just crazy until June. So please get involved, please sign up. Please come and to all our concerts, to our shows, to our musicals, to our dance shows. You won't be disappointed. This is just the beginning. Mr. Bond.
Thank you very much, Mr. Cooper. When Mr. Cooper says it's a Brentwood School record, he hasn't really factored in my speech yet. So I have about 2.5 hours worth of material. So if you just settle down, sit comfortably, and I'll begin. No, I promise you I won't keep you very long, but just a few thank yous from me. I won't repeat all of the thank yous from Mrs. Chapman, from Mr. Cooper, that have already been given, but I have got three sets of thank yous that I would like to give. First of all, I'd like to thank Andrew Keeping, our adjudicator. I first met Andrew in, I think it was 2007, at one of the schools I worked at. Two schools ago, I was head of sixth form there, and we had a Friday lecture every week for the sixth formers, and every week we'd have a guest speaker, and I exaggerate not when I say every year I looked forward to Andrew's visit more than any other for a number of reasons. One, he came and he did a talk that was full of storytelling and interspersed with his amazing musicianship. So he played his guitar, he told stories, and it just the hour that he spoke to us passed in an instant. But apart from that, he's also just a thoroughly, thoroughly decent chap. Andrew won't tell you about it, but I will because I think it's important. He and his family have looked after and fostered autistic children for many, many years, and he's now heavily involved on a national level with that. So I was absolutely delighted when we were able to get Andrew to come to us tonight. And I think he's done an amazing job. You know, I knew he would, but I think he deserves a huge round of applause. Thank you very much, Andrew. Secondly, this evening is really all about our students, and the biggest group of those students are, of course, our wonderful new Year 7s. Some of them have been at Brentwood School since they were 3 years old. Some of them have been at Brentwood School for 3 weeks. But the purpose of doing this evening, when we do it, is to make sure that however long they have been here, they are now Brentwood School students on the same sort of basis, and hopefully they feel very much part of the Brentwood School community now. They do a great job every year. I've just been chatting to some parents in the audience, and they say that every year they get more comfortable on the stage, they get more enthusiastic, and they just genuinely show the passion that Brentwood School is all about. All I will say, Year 7s, is that if you ever lose that passion and enthusiasm and become a grumpy and stroppy teenager, we've got that on film. And we will not hesitate to show you when you are that. No, I'm sure you won't. And in a few years' time, in probably 5 or 7 years' time, I wonder which of you will be standing in front of the stage rather than on it, doing what our Upper Six have done this evening. And that's a challenge for you. And last, but certainly by no means least, this event is also about our senior musicians, our senior students. And we've heard a lot about that tonight already. We've heard the fact that they've pulled all this together in 10 days. They have spent many, many more hours than that over the summer doing the arrangements, planning the compositions, and so on. They are exceptional. They are exceptional young people. They are kind young people. They are enthusiastic. They genuinely look forward to welcoming our Year 7s into our community, and that's what I think makes this school such a special place. So, biggest round of applause for our Year 7s and our Upper Six and Senior School students. Well done. And probably the toughest gig of the night, and I'm not talking about Mr. Hurd having to reverse the buggy out at the beginning, probably the toughest gig of the night are compares. Now, I'm not sure about you, but when I was 17 or 18, the idea of standing in front of well over 1,000 people, having to try and make them laugh, to try and link different segments of a competition like this, would have absolutely terrified me. This is my fifth house music of various sorts in Brentwood, and I think tonight, I think we've seen two superstars doing the comparing. So a huge, huge well done to Joe and Rhea. Well done. And I think, Mr. Cooper, that's probably about it. So we probably have hit a record, and hope you've enjoyed it. Thanks for being here, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you very much.